Hello and welcome for the poster number 614. Today we are September 5, 2020, and I base myself about yesterday's poster that I made with a Japanese font. And I will do something in this way today too, because I find it was pretty interesting. Yesterday's poster looks like this, and today I will do something like that too. So get ready, because I'm starting it right now. Just remove that now. I want this brain in the center of the canvas. Here we are. I want to change this font, or maybe not. It's fine. Just put it in white. I will increase, no, I won't increase the size of the brain. I will decrease the size of the font after put it in white color. And place it into the brain. Like this. In the center too. Let's draw a rectangle behind the font. I say behind the font. Here. Black, or with this color, this dark gray, let this dark gray for the moment. Scene is good. Yeah, that's fine. That's fine like that. So what's the next step? I will play with the brain. I will duplicate some part of the brain. Something like a circle, like this. Command C, Command V to copy and paste it. I have my brain selected there. And Command T, I increase the highest I can around at 120%, and I go to place it behind the brain like this. Let's duplicate it one more time. I want it smaller now. Like that. Looks fine. For now, let's play with types, duplicate that, and write the title, mentor, duplicate, type, process, and it is the number 13 of the miniseries. Let's select all of them, place it outside of my folder, layout folder, Command T, take an anchor point and grow them until you are satisfied with the size. Okay, like that looks good. I like the pixelate effect. Yeah, like this. You'll be down. Mantle. Yeah, let the eyes go there, arrive there, direct to the circle, the shape of the brand, the Japanese title. Proc, like a prune now. Duplicate it, make it smaller than this. Make it down, not up, or not too close to proc process. Here it is, maybe a little bit more in the side, outside. Number 13. Number 13, and that's fine like this. Make this one a little bit down too. Be more playful with the white areas and the repetition between the lines there created by the font. Whoops, I don't want a V there. I want my number 1 and 1, 3 there too. It's fine, that's too much in the middle. Let's go down and see what happens. Looks better like that. Let's try something. Whoa. Yeah, please move there. Make it a vertical type. Go to paragraph, center, and of course, increase the leading. How does it look like? Good, change nothing. Yeah, finally. Font is too strong, Corso G. Let's light regular. Extra light looks also fine too. I want it much smaller. Like this, it's still a little bit too big. Yes, it is. Yeah, clearly, I want to have a big difference between the bold typeface there and scene one there. I want a high contrast, and that's high contrasted enough. It's enough high contrasted now. Yeah, good. Increase the leading. And see how it looks like. Make it very high. I like this centered brain there. Man, let's try like this time. And see if it's understandable. It looks okay. So next step is to add some geometric shape again. Let's try a square there. Okay, I want you behind the brain. Let's add a bit of depth with those shape. Make the second square a bit smaller in a purpose of contrasting with the different areas. Okay, make it much smaller. Just notice a CD there, the L is over the title, so I select the two mental text and I go to put them down like this. So yesterday I added the grunge effect too. So let's continue. Yeah, it looked like a splatter and stuff like this. Create another new layer, and I would like to change the color with the light gray. Change the shape to, I want spray paint too, maybe. Oh, I say maybe. Wow. Yeah. I feel like if it's really not me who did that, because it's really not me who did that spray paint. So let's see if there's something more. Okay, this one is okay. Oh. Ah, that's better. Okay, let's create another layer and place this one above the brain, but under the title. and go there. Yeah, too much contrast there. In white, like fits the stroke of the rectangle there, who have something like problem. Not the second one. Let's see what another spray paint option I have. I already click on. It can look nice. But not. Okay. I see them all approximately by using some of them. So let's choose something else now. According what I have. On my brushes. Let's use the color. Why not a blue color? It will change from the red I used yesterday. Let's use a 90-degree. Yeah, it looks pretty strange there.